Hello everyone, welcome to Coding Hub. So today I am going to start with a new topic in Java called switch case, that is called switch statement. So as you can see, it is written comparing exact values. Basically, it is a conditional statement of Java which is generally substituted with if-else structure when the number of optional or alternates are more than 2 with a single condition. It is generally implemented to give the user multiple options for performing multiple tasks. Okay, so let me show you the exact syntax of switch case. So before that, let me come to the theoretical portion which I have said just now. The switch statement provides another way to decide which statement to be executed next. So the statement which will be executed is decided by switch. If the conditions for switch matches, then only it's going to execute the conditions. Okay. The switch statements evaluate an expression, then attempt to match the result to one of several possible cases. So if this matches, it's allowed to match with the result of several possible cases. The match must be an exact match. Okay, the match must be an exact match. So for the syntax of switch, it starts with switch with the expressions, the choice which we are giving for this. So switch having an expression, particular expression, it basically checks. Then it looks for the cases. So if the case value matches with the switch value provided, then the statement gets executed. There can be many cases with their corresponding value. Okay, so we do have a case C is small and switch is also small, so with the values. Okay, next point, each case contains a value. Okay, each case, you can see I have said, contains a value and a list of statement. After this case, it is having a list of statement to be executed. Okay, the flow of the control transfer to the statement associated with the first case value, then that matches. Okay, it's allow only if the case value matches with the switch value provided. Okay, now the syntax which I have said, it is, see the general syntax of switch statement, switch and the case are reserved words. So these are reserve word, okay, these are the reserve word having their own specific meaning. Okay, so keyword, these are basically keywords, so that's why they are reserve word and they start with a small letter. Okay, so switch, expression, case with their corresponding value with the statement. If the expression match value 3, then control jumps to here. So if this case value 3 matches, then only it is going to jump to this particular statement. Otherwise, it does not match, then it is not going to jump in that. So if case value 2 match, then it is going to jump to the statement list 2. Okay, so it is having case. Okay, now in switch statement we basically use break. So what is the use of break? Break is used as a jump statement which transfer the control out of the switch. Okay, so the break statement can be used as the last statement in the each case statement. So this is used in the last, okay, of every case. So this is the case 1 with the value 1 and this is the case 2 with the value, and you can see the break statement is used at the last. Okay, The break statement causes control to the transfer to the end of the switch statement. So it already have said that it transferred the control out of the structure. If the break statement is not provided, suppose if the break statement, we do not provide any break statement, what is going to happen? So if the break statement is not used, then the controller flow will continue into the next case. Suppose this case value 1, in this particular case we does not give this break statement, and our case value matches with the switch value provided, then what it does, it execute the next case value 2 and its corresponding statement. So this, if we do not provide breaks, this leads to another condition called fall through in Java. I will come in details what is fall through. For time being, fall through basically execute every cases if it does not provide any break. Okay, so this is the concept of fall through. In details I will explain what is fall through. Let me give one example of switch case. Okay, let me give one example so that it will be clear. So this is how it look like. So switch with the option, that is a choice. If case, that is A, then it will be increasing the counter. Then if it is found, then it is going to transfer the control out of the switch block. Okay, that's why they have made an arrow. It is going to transfer the control out of the block. Okay, so case if match with the value, then the value B is going to be incremented and break will be applied. If it is matched with the C, so C is going to be incremented and break will be applied. This is a simple example of switch. So hope you have understood the syntax and what is switch case and why we use switch case. Everything you have understood. Let me go to another point. That is very interesting. Let me show you that also. Okay. No break I have already explained. If you do not apply any break, then what will happen? So fall through condition will execute it, because if case A executed, it is going to execute the rest of these conditions. Okay, this is the main portion. Default. We do have a default, which is basically an optional portion in switch case. So what does it does? Basically default execute when none of the case value matches the switch value provided. There should be a one default statement that should be executed. So we do have else. If not executed, then we have a else, that portion should be executed. So default is act like a same. So if none of the case value matches with the switch value provided, default get executed. So a switch statement can have optional default. The default case has not associated value, so value is not associated with it, as cases have, switch does, default does not have, and simply used as a reserve word default. So it is also a reserve word, like a keyword. If the default is not present, the control will transfer to it if no case value matches with the switch value. Means there is no such output will be produced if the switch value not matches with the case value provided. If there is no default, no value matches and the control falls through the statement after the switch. Okay, this is clear. And this is the example with the help of default. Okay, so last we do have a default in switch statement. So thank you for watching and please do subscribe my channel. So thank you.